Hi guys and welcome to this video. This is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. In this video we're going to show you how to do some advanced CSS customization so we can turn our drop-down submenu into something a lot more interesting with some images in the background. I'll show you, for example, over here. We're going to create something like this. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing we want to do is we want to make this menu stretch out horizontally so that we can actually place images behind our links here. So let's just inspect this. Which is a right click and inspect, or F12. And there's our submenu. And I think what I want is a navless UI. Okay, so that's what we got here. That's what I'm looking for right there. The nav list, unordered list. So we're going to add the CSS attribute of width, 100 VW, which is a viewport width, which should stretch it out across the screen. Okay, let's have a look at that. Yeah, as you can see, that stretched it all out. That's what I'm looking for along here. And the next thing I want to do is I want to make sure these are in the center. It looks like they are at the moment. And we want to get rid of that blue border up there as well. So I'll make sure this is centered, so we'll do text align, center, and, okay, I see there's another one up there, so we want to just give that the important attribute here. That way it'll overshadow the other one up there. And also, we don't want that light blue border that's at the top there, so we'll say border none. That should have got rid of that. Yep, that's more like it. Starting to shape up a bit there. Okay, now we just need to copy this and go to our theme options, and down at the bottom of our theme options, Divi theme options, at the bottom of the page you'll see the custom CSS here. Let's make a new entry in here, call it submenu. I always like to put a title in here so that if you're looking through a lot of CSS, you can find the section you're looking for easily. With code editors, it's usually numbered, so you can find it by looking at the inspector and finding the line number. But with Divi, it hasn't got it here. And everything we're doing here, I'm using the Divi thing, which is absolutely awesome. But this will work with any WordPress site. You just have to use a bit of custom CSS. With some themes, you may need to create a child theme so that the CSS doesn't get overwritten if the theme updates. Okay, let's paste in what we just created just now. Don't need that one. And save our changes. Refresh, and that should stay the same, but now that submenu on our third menu here should stretch all the way across like it did just now. There we go. But I want those to be over to the left. and I want to give it some space so that we can actually put an image behind it. And each one I want to make a consistent width so that we can put a decent image behind it. So let's select a full width menus list item submenu. So it'll be full width menu list item list item. There we have what we want, the dot nav list item list item. Now we want to give it some space at the top so we can fit an image in there. So let's give it padding top and 275 pixels, and that should make it a lot deeper. Yep, that's like it. So we got room to put an image up here. And I want it over to the left hand side, so I need to float these back over to the left hand side. So we'll float. Let's put a colon in. Semicolon will not work. Left. Let's check that out. That's better, they're over the left hand side here. And I want them to be, I don't know, 200, 250, something like that, wide. So let's give them a width of, well, in between 225, let's say. Won't look a whole lot different, I don't think. But that's about right. So we've got enough room for a nice image to go in the background there. So let's just save this to our custom CSS. What I'm doing is left clicking and dragging across to select it and hitting Control C to copy it. And let's drop down where we were just now. Don't need those last two because we did not change those. Okay, that's good. And let's do a quick save. Now comes the fun part. This is where we put the actual images in that we want in the background here. So we want our nice background image here somewhere. If you look at these list items here, as I'm mousing over them, you can see they're going green where the padding is. And each one's got an individual ID. Menu item 799, 801, 802. 762, and it's an ID. So to add attributes to it or do what we want to do, we can, in our custom CSS, because it's an ID, we can do hashtag menu item and the number and then add the attributes that we want. So let's go back to our custom CSS. Drop down a couple, hashtag, because it's an ID, menu, dash item, dash whatever the number was. I think it was 799, wasn't it? I may have to change that in a minute if that's incorrect, but I think that's what it was. Okay, and what do we want to do to it? We want to add an image to the background. So that's going to be background image. Don't need a capital B there, it's just habit. Background image. And with the background image, you have to give it a URL. So we'll do colon URL. Let's open some regular brackets here, some round brackets. And in between them is where we want to put the URL. And you may say, well, how do I know the URL of the picture I want to put in there or the image? What we'll do is create a page. Can be a test page or any sort of page you want. I'll just delete this. You don't need to keep this page. Don't need to use the Divi builder. You can if you want. You can just use the default editor and just hit your add media tab. I've uploaded the pictures I'm going to use already here. So just insert the picture that you want to use. Now it's into this page here. Now if we go up to the text tab at the top here, this is how we find the URL. If you scroll across and look for source, SRC, there it is, equals, here's the URL we want from that opening inverted comma to the closing one, and include both of them there. Make sure you include both inverted commas there. Copy it, Control C, go back to our custom CSS and just paste that in between those two little round brackets there. And do a quick save. Actually, I want to make sure I got a little semicolon on the end there, because we will be adding more attributes and that you do need it. So let's save that again. And let's have a look at our site now. There should be a little image on that first one. Do a refresh. And let's have a look at our drop down. And there's no image there. Great. Did I get the ID wrong? /799. Let's have a look. 799, that looks right. Okay, background image URL, what's going wrong? Oh, I see, we've got a gap after the URL there. We want no gap between the URL and the first round bracket there. Make sure you've got no gap, or else it won't work like mine didn't work. Save that again and try it again. And refresh. And hopefully this time, there it is, there's our image right there. That's fine, let's just inspect that a minute. So I'm going to do the same thing for the next four images. There it is right there. So I want to perhaps give it a separator by having a border on the right hand side. So let's give it a of right hand border of say 2 pixels solid. Well, white, of course, that's going to work nice, isn't it? FFF. And we'll give it a border on the bottom. A little bit thicker, let's make it say 3 pixels. And we'll use a blue color that I've been using, and we want a solid border rather than dashed. You probably won't see it because it's going to be the same color, I think, as that drop down. Let's have a look, see. Oh, you can see it, that's okay, it's slightly darker blue, that's fine. That's fine. Okay, now we're going to rinse and repeat for the rest of these, which is real easy. Now let's just do that quickly. I'll copy this over. I want those two attributes right there. And we'll add those to our custom CSS. That up. Okay, so we've got, that's what we want. Now we want to do the same thing for the rest of the menu items. So there's three more of them. I will copy this three times. One, two, three. And now we want to change our numbers there. Let's just check those because they've got to be right. 801, 802, and 762. 762, I believe. Now, my images, I've done it simply. I've done them 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we've got 4 there. So let's go 5. I'm not putting much thought into it. Obviously, you want to put more thought into yours. 2, 1. Okay, let's save that. And back to the site. We should now have images for all of those. Let's refresh. Let's get rid of our inspector just for the moment. That's it. We've now got background images for all of those, separated by that white line there. And I think what we need to do, obviously, is get rid of that background color of this submenu there. We can do that. We don't have to do that with CSS. I think it'll actually let us do that in the page edit menu. Let's just go back to the page. In fact, I can hit the edit page button up here. And there's the full width menu that we've been working on here. So if we open it up, go to the design, it should let us change that background color. This one right here, drop down menu, background color. I can just pull that all the way down so it's transparent. And do a quick save. Update the page. And preview our changes. And there we go, that background's gone now. So there we have it. That's the way to add some images to the background of your submenu and add some borders with CSS. Quite a lot to it, but once you've done one, it's really easy. So I hope you found that useful. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.